In the penultimate video of the Getting Started experience, you'll learn how to export your clips and sequences. Before exporting, you need to be aware of one potential preparation. Currently, Smoke can only export entire clips. If you want to export an entire sequence, then you can export straight away. If you wish to export a section of a sequence, you need to make a copy of just that section for the export. Isolating that section makes a new clip that can be exported in its entirety. Now let's perform an export. Select the clip or sequence that you would like to export. There are three ways in which you can start the export process. You can click on the File menu and choose Export. This will bring up the file browser. Or you could right-click on the selected clip or sequence and choose Export in the pop-up menu. This will also bring up the file browser pop-up window. Or lastly, you can click on the Media Hub tab at the bottom of the screen. Here you will have the file browser sitting next to the media panel. In all cases, you use the file browser to navigate through the folders to your chosen destination. In my case, I will navigate to the Mac desktop. The benefit of using the Media Hub over the other two methods is that you can drag and drop a clip or multiple clips into the file browser. The Media Export pop-up window will appear. First, you will see how many clips are selected for export in the title bar. The next step is to choose what you are going to export. There are a variety of options, but we will export a movie file. Once you have selected the type of export, you can now choose a format preset from the next pull-down menu. There are a lot of presets you can choose from, including ProRes and DNX HD presets. So I'll choose the ProRes 422 preset for my example. The description tells you what you are about to create, and you can edit the file name in the text box. If you're happy with the preset, then just press the export button. If you wish to tweak and fine-tune the settings, then click Show Advanced Options. This will expose all the various options for you to adjust. The Movie Options tab contains the general settings for this export. It contains the format, the type of compression, and whether or not to include audio on export. In the middle of the window is the file naming settings. The file name entry gives a preview of your file name. Just below it is the naming pattern text entry where you can set the naming conventions of the file. You can obviously edit the text box and enter in your own unique name. Alternatively, you can use the token system to let Smoke name your exported file using a series of variables. For example, in the Add pull-down, you can choose the name of your file based on clip name, date, reel, resolution, workstation, etc. You can edit these variables in the text box to create your own unique naming convention. You can also create a folder structure during the export. For example, add a project token. Next, cut and paste the token to the beginning of the pattern. Finally, place a forward slash to define it as a directory. You can get as detailed as you like with the file name. So you could add a width token to the file name to define the resolution. You set this up as you see fit. At the bottom of the export window is resolution. The default setting is to export out the same resolution as the selected media. Or you can set your own export resolution with various resize options. There is also a color management section if you need to correct the image for its delivery format. Moving on. The Audio tab will give you the various audio settings if audio is to be included in the export. This includes compression and audio mixdown settings to handle sequences with multiple audio tracks. So there are a variety of options you can change. If you want to keep any of the changes as a new preset, click the Save button. In the pop-up window, you give the preset a name. You can also type a description to remind you of the settings. Finally, you have the Export Presets Visibility option. You can choose to have the export preset only available for this project. Or you can share this preset across all the projects on the system. These presets will appear in the Format Preset list after you save them. To perform the export, just click the export button. The export kicks off in the background and you can carry on working. To monitor the export process, you can see a progress indicator at the bottom left of the screen. Exporting is a background process, and you can monitor this wherever you are in Smoke. If you want more detail, you can click on the arrows and this will bring up the console. The console gives you a detailed listing of the background processing. To hide the console, just click anywhere in the interface and it will disappear. Once the process is complete and there are no more messages being displayed at the bottom of the interface, you can go to your designated location and see the exported file. So the job is done and your deliverable is exported. In the next video, you'll learn how to back up your project for archival purposes. Please move on to the next video to continue your Smoke Getting Started experience.